Coleman family last year, and they've embraced me. They've embraced the Michan. For those of you that don't know what that means, Ken, you mind telling everyone what Michan means?
White boy.
There you go. So now it is our turn to embrace you two. Did you guys know that Han and Becky have been dating for 15 years?
No way.
Of course we do. 15 years. I just wonder when the heck Han knew. But when you know, you know. Love has no agenda, but it seeks only itself. It is beyond our understanding of time. It can't be put on hold. It can't be rushed. Hell, they can't even be carried to the altar. 15 years, man? I got to sit down with Han and Becky last week. I wanted to get together with them and ask them some questions so their answers could help me craft what it was that I was going to say here today. And I saw what a 15-year relationship looks like. Man, we got about 9 more, and then we might want to look at other options. But did you guys know that Han sings to Becky all the time? Did you guys know this? It's true. Becky confirmed it. It was special to witness this too. And it was surprisingly, delightfully bad. I knew Han would sound terrible, but he was charming. And he put himself out on the line, you know? And he wasn't just singing songs to her. He was changing the lyrics. For those of you, yes, for those of you that don't know, Han von Hanners is a wordsmith, a poet, a Weird Al Yankovic specifically. But he is a master, though. Just one look at Becky as he sings, and you know Han has achieved the goal he set out to accomplish. That Becky laugh. You? I'm telling you, this boy can make her laugh, man. And he loves doing it. You know the laugh. The loud, air-piercing, from the gut and honest, true laugh that she has. That's Han's doing a lot of times. Han, if you want, you may bow. But Casanova over here doesn't just sing with his voice, though. It was early on, and from Han's other end, that he trumpeted a siren song that Becky literally laid down for. I'm of course referencing the magical Han hotbox, the Dutch oven that Becky willfully took as oxygen was running low and Han's back end was preheating sheets. My brother-in-law, master of seduction, has been taking beautiful Becky's breath away ever since Batman Begins hit theaters and Guitar Hero first hit the market. But all the years and laughter aren't without its arguments. Maybe you heard about the hole in my mother-in-law's bedroom door, or the holes in some of Han's walls. But fights always get intense where love's involved. In every fight, love's lesson is the same. It's better to be together than it is to be right. And it seems to me that as clear as that lesson is, none of us learned it the first time. I don't think we're meant to. I don't think we're meant. We are made that way. It seems to me that love would have its teachings learned throughout the entirety of our lives. For love is a journey, it is no destination. So when you love each other, that means that there is no one else you'd rather be with, live with, laugh with, struggle with, celebrate with, trust more, do more for, fight for, or fight with. And after 15 years, you too, must find each other woven into the very fabric of your guys' lives. You can probably anticipate each other's needs and wants. You probably have a bunch of inside jokes and a bank of treasured memories and a million moments. You're in love, and among other things, This means that the good you have found in your relationship blows the bad out of the water. This means that you freely admit to sacrificing self-interest, that you feel the interdependence of your relationship with one another is greater than your individual independence, that the we is greater and more beautiful than the me. And we are all here because we agree with you two. Han and Becky is more beautiful than Han or Becky. So, Han, will you take Becky to be your wife? Do you promise to love, honor, and trust her in sickness and in health, in adversity and prosperity, and to be true and loyal to her for as long as you both shall live? And Becky, will you take Han? Do you promise to love, honor, and trust him in sickness and in health, in adversity and prosperity, and to be true and loyal to him so long as you both shall live? Now for the exchanging of the rings. The ring is a symbol of the unbroken circle of love. Love freely given has no beginning and no end, no giver and no receiver. Repeat after me. This ring is a token of my love. I marry you with this ring, with all that I have and all that I owe. Go run that back and walk your pumps. This ring is a token of my love. This ring is a token of my love.
This ring is a token of my love.
I marry you with this ring.
I marry you with this ring.
With all that I have and all that I am.
With all that I have and all that I am.
Now, Becky, repeat after me. This ring is a token of my love.
This ring is a token of my love.
I marry you with this ring.
I marry you with this ring.
With all that I have and all that I am.
With all that I have and all that I am.
With the rings on each other's fingers, you may now put your lips to this woman for the first time as husband and wife. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Wang. Han and Becky would now like to show their appreciation for their parents and extend some flowers to them.